Hey Capricorn, welcome to your October 2022 tarot reading. This is going to be a reading for Capricorn Sun, Moon, and Rising, other placements, cross watchers, and whoever else feels led to watch and listen to this reading. And whenever you find this reading, there just might be messages here for you. Happy October, happy Halloween, you guys. I'm very excited to do the readings this month. By the time you watch this, it could very well be the beginning of November, but I did not want to let October pass by without retouching and revisiting some of the major shifts and energies that we've experienced over this month. So for you, Capricorn, I would just really like to say that Saturn, your ruling planet, is going direct towards the end of October. I believe it is on October 23rd that Saturn went direct. This is huge news. There's going to be a lot of boundaries and restrictions that you've been facing over the past 4 months or so, 4 to 6 months or so, that are going to be removed karmically. Okay, whenever Saturn goes back direct, there is a shift in time management and responsibility. The future becomes more clear. Maybe I will have time, literally, to record a completely separate video on this extremely huge shift. There's some other things going on as well, but for now, I will just say that there is a eclipse in Scorpio that I'm recording this reading on around October 25th. That's going to be significant. And we do have a full moon in Taurus in a couple weeks around November 9th. The full moon in Aries in October may have been significant for you as a cardinal sign as well. Perhaps some compromise. There may be some other astrology, but I really just wanted to remind you and let you guys know about Saturn. I, for one, am very, very relieved to know that Saturn is going to begin moving forward in the sky. So this month, I am using two decks. I have the Witch's Tarot and the Nightmare Before Christmas deck, which I bring out around Halloween. This is my second Halloween using these cards, so they're very brand new and a little bit different. So I'm hoping it adds an element of fun and creativity to the readings this month. We will be getting into those cards in a moment, but what I would like to start with is the Witch's Tarot. I've done a significant amount of shuffling off camera to connect with you, Capricorn, and I do have your ruling card here, the Devil card. This is how the Devil card is depicted. Sorry that my camera won't focus. Perhaps that's a bit of a metaphor. Focus and clarity. So this is the shadow side. I really like that in this deck we have the shadow side. So a little bit different than what you might be used to seeing as the Devil card, but I actually like this a bit more, okay? There's these two individuals, and then there's this mysterious figure in the back, lots of light. So this card talks about codependence and shackles, people, places, and things that we feel bound and stuck to, that we want released from. It could be addiction, obsession, lust, right? Your own shadow side. So this is the Capricorn card for now. This is the card I shuffle and connect to whenever I'm reading for your sign. I would like to see what kind of a story is being told in the cards after a significant amount of shuffling. This may resonate a bit sooner because it lets me know the main energy themes of impact that are around you and influencing you. So we know the Devil card represents your energy. Let's see what's going on. So we have the Eight of Swords. Speaking of people, places, and things that you may feel trapped in, Capricorn, we have the Eight of Swords. You or someone else is definitely feeling trapped, okay? Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy here with the Swords. Some of you guys may have that energy in your birth chart or you're connecting with someone who does. But this is talking about a temporary situation that you feel kind of bound to. And it's very interesting. My camera keeps unfocusing, and this has not ever happened to me. So there's definitely something that you need to focus in on. Something is not clear. Something is a little hazy. You can't see something clearly because we do have the Eight of Swords, which is a woman here, an individual, I should say, who was blindfolded, surrounded by these thoughts without a way out that is clear, but this is temporary, okay? And in what way are you keeping yourself stuck, Capricorn? In what way are you, keeping yourself detached from your emotions? Because someone here has retracted a bit emotionally, and I think they feel quite in the dark because we do have the High Priestess coming out next, Pisces energy, Cancer energy. Scorpio season starting and perhaps, you know, making you feel a bit stuck or restricted or trapped secretly. There is some secrets here. Someone here is secretly feeling stuck or feeling stuck because of secrets of the unknown, the veil that is thinning. I mean, this is quite a depiction of darkness. And we even have the shadow side. So you're being forced to see something, Capricorn, eventually, about yourself, about those who are around you, about a situation that makes you feel stuck. You're going to need to tap into your intuition without seeing. You're going to have to utilize your feelings and your intelligence. Okay, this could be a spiritual prison of some sort, or perhaps you're secretly keeping yourself stuck subconsciously. Okay, so this could be a secret that emerges that you finally see. We have the Eight of Cups coming out next, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy, the full moon being extremely important, perhaps Aries full moon that we had September 9th or October 9th, the Taurus full moon that we have approaching November 9th. So there's some walking away here, the nighttime hours, the dark unknown energies with the blindfold, with the shadow side and the guy covering his eyes, the High Priestess being the ultimate secret card of subconscious. I just saw 555 on the clock. That happened to me in my Sagittarius reading. So some of you may be dealing with a Sagittarius. Also with the moon, some of you may have Capricorn moon. There will be a Capricorn new moon in December, probably around Christmas or the 25th. But your moon sign, you may need to listen for your moon sign because the High Priestess is ruled by the moon. She rules anything that's going on subconsciously. And we have the Eight of Cups. Okay, when the moon is in crescent form or the full moon may be important when someone is walking away secretly, maybe they're returning to something secretly. Someone here may be secretly returning to a situation that once made them feel trapped and stuck in a toxic codependent situation. It was unhealthy. This could be actual prison for very few of you out there, but someone here specifically feels this secretly, intuitively, subconsciously, or at nighttime, or maybe there's significant dreams that are important. But someone here has intuitively removed themselves. They have emotionally departed in either now or by November 9th. They may walk away or return because there's some disappointment here that someone's hiding, some secrets, okay? Things that just are not very emotionally fulfilling. So they're left behind and you're walking towards your wish fulfillment and away from people, places, and things that, you know, have really just kind of disappointed you. Someone here wants to escape a situation that they're feeling secretly trapped in, okay? And they want their happiness. They want their clarity, the sun. This is Leo energy. Someone here may have children. There's going to be some conflict when things are clarified. Someone here does not want to fight anymore. There may be an argument or some kind of mental conflict that is discussed through communication. Travel. I see a text message where there's a little bit of mental conflict or arguing, specifically for someone out there listening. After something becomes clear, after someone walks away from or towards their happiness, whether children are involved or not, Leo energy perhaps. But this is all about Scorpio season. We do have the Scorpio new moon coming up October 25th. So that might be around the time where someone just really doesn't want to fight anymore. They don't want any secrets or disappointments or conflict or mind games. They're kind of laying down their sword. Someone here, I don't want to say is accepting defeat, but they feel really stuck where they're at, okay, secretly. And this is a spiritual prison, subconsciously restricted. And we are back to the Devil card. So just know you are battling and facing your shadow side, which is true work of a soldier. That is not for the meek. That is not for the weak. So hopefully that resonated with some of you guys out there. Let's go ahead and dive into the Nightmare Before Christmas deck and see what's going on here. So this may resonate in October or perhaps in Halloween. And we do have, I'm going to reshuffle Capricorn because this came out a little too quick. But we have the Star and the Six of Wands. Some of you guys, there's some kind of wish, okay? Some kind of inspiration, and you're getting acknowledgement, recognition, a promotion. Aquarius energy here. What do we have for Capricorn? Guidance for Capricorn as we reflect on October 2022, Halloween 2022. What does Capricorn need to hear the most? Sun, moon, and rising. Okay, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Look what just came back out. So trust your intuition, Capricorn. I should have trusted mine when it came. Now the messages are a little bit different, but we're going to keep this. Some of you have Aquarius energy. You could be born on the Capricorn Aquarius cusp, January 17th to the 25th. You could be dealing with an Aquarius, but this is hope and inspiration. Trust your intuition. the first time. Things are aligning in the way, don't second guess something. Okay, let things happen. So victory, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy in the star, some kind of wish for recognition, some kind of wish for attention, admiration, hope. There's something here that is victorious that takes place in October, something that you're winning at, succeeding at, that is really inspiring you. And we have the Magician at the bottom of the deck, Mercury's energy, Virgo, Gemini. Looking at your Mercury placement, some of you may have Mercury in Aquarius. But you're very victorious and inspirational when it comes to this wish, when it comes to healing and hope. So hopefully, literally, you guys have not given up hope when it comes to relationships, connections, emotional choices, and other things in your life too. Because you truly are succeeding at something. And the more you win and succeed and become victorious, the more inspiring you're going to have. So don't lose hope. You're going to win. Okay. So what else do we have for Capricorn? Let's see what else comes out for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, and Rising. And we have the Ten of Cups. This card has come out for a lot of my readings so far. So emotional fulfillment, happiness, family, relationships, home environment, if I haven't mentioned that, may be important. There's something here that, I know there was depictions of emotional fulfillment that wasn't happening before in your reading, but now it's coming up here. This is what's inspiring you, this home environment, this relationship, family situation. You've kind of outgrown something emotionally. You're getting very close to experiencing new feelings, new love, new emotion. And we have the Nine of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So this has something to do with not backing down, not giving up when there's been a lot of battles when it comes to feeling emotionally fulfilled in your home, family, or relationships, or in general. So there's something that's worth fighting for here. There's a little bit of territorial energy. Maybe some of you guys are trying to protect your family, protect your home, fight for your home, not give up on your home, relationship, or family. But there's some kind of battle depicted there as well. And there's some wounds that you have in that area. What else do we have for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, and Rising? Capricorn, Sun, Moon, and Rising, October. And we have the Seven of Swords. Interesting. I'm going to have to remember that this came out for you because it's important for the rest of my reading. We have the Seven. Oh, wow. Okay, so Seven of Swords, the Lovers card. Sorry, these cards are very new, so some of them stick together. So let's see what we have here. The Seven of Swords, the Seven of Needles. I don't know if I told you yet, but we don't have swords, wands, cups, or pentacles in this deck. We have needles, potions, candles, and presents. We have the Lovers card. This is my favorite card in this deck. We got Jack and Sally, which is the dynamic duo, divine couple, soulmate energy, twin flame energy, meant to be. But this is a choice. There's a major choice. But we have this with the Seven of Swords. So there could be a third party. There could be some kind of choice or strategy. But the Seven of Swords talks about deception, lies. So I don't know if this has to do with a home or family, if someone's cheating or lying or stealing. We have the Knight of Pentacles, the Knight of Presence. This is your energy as an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Someone here is trying to move slow when it comes to connections. Maybe because they have, you know, multiple connections or because of a choice. You just want to move forward with a plan. That's what inspires you the most. We have the Emperor. Some of you could be dealing with Aries. This is Santa Claus himself. Okay, so this is about, you know, your empire that someone has to run, their business, daddy energy, anybody in authority. Okay, the man of the house, father figure energy, and we have Temperance that came out with this. Love this card, Sagittarius. So we have an Aries and a Sagittarius here. There could definitely be some lies or deception. You're needing to practice moderation and balance, fairness, experiment a little bit. Okay, there's some kind of strategy and patience here, knowing who you are, moving a bit slower with a plan, being practical, dependable, secure. Especially when it comes to choices and connections and relationships. I got Gemini, Aries, and Sagittarius here that might be immediately important. And in the bottom of the deck, same for Libra, is the Empress. Okay, mother figure energy, Venus energy, attraction, abundance. Even if you're not a mother, even if you're not a woman, you can kind of possess these qualities of those nurturing. There's something here that needs to be taken care of. A lot of abundance and love, attraction, and money. So very, very interesting, Capricorn. Your mother figures may be important and interesting. I freaking knew it. Couldn't let you go without showing you the devil. I'm the oogie boogie man. Ooh, whoa. Yeah, Capricorn, you are the oogie boogie man in this deck. And we have the Seven of Wands. So, yeah, you're definitely fighting some kind of karmic, toxic, codependent situation that you want freed from, you know, that shadow side energy. Some of you guys, Venus in Capricorn is important. Your mother may be toxic or Capricorn, or maybe this is a feminine energy. There's something going on there, but I am just tickled that the Devil card showed up for you. I had a feeling that it would. So I have a little bit of a surprise to end your reading, Capricorn. I am doing energetic trick or treat this month. So I have put 12 pieces of paper in here that say trick, 12 pieces of paper that say treat. So we're going to energetically trick or treat for Capricorn just to kind of see what's going on, see if you pull trick or treats for October, more specifically Halloween. So trick or treat for Capricorn, please. Okay, so one fell out. I'm not gonna do the one that fell out. Some of them are falling out, like the one I pulled for Sagittarius, it fell out on its own. So this is a significant message about fate versus free will. I am choosing as your tarot reader free will for you. So maybe that's a message. Sometimes we're in control. Sometimes we allow a higher power to be in control. I believe we co-create in that way. Let's see whether you got trick or treat, Capricorn. And when you choose for yourself, you choose right, honey. I should have kept the other one out just to see if it was trick. So you're pulling treat. This is positive news. Halloween is going to be positive. There were some positive things in October. For those who pull treats, at least one positive or good thing will occur that is in your favor, like the Nine of Cups. Joy, pleasure, satisfaction is exactly the intentions I had for those who pull treat this month. So thank you so much, Capricorn, for listening and watching. Everything you need to know about this reading is going to be below in the description box. I just want to remind you guys how important it is to focus. Not sure why this happened, as far as my camera blurring, but I think it has something to do metaphorically with the way you're seeing things, your vision. But as I was saying, everything you need to know is beneath in the description box, including how to get a personal reading with me if you're interested. If I don't connect with you in that way, I hope to see you back in one of my next videos. Bye.